Welcome to show 304.
Yeah, howdy.
How are you doing? We're here in the shed room. I'm not really sure what we called it.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just my house, really.
Chris's house.
Yeah. Now, someone did actually mention last week that we need to speak up and get a better backdrop. Did you see that?
I did see that, yeah. Welcome any constructive responses. Yeah.
To be fair, if we turned it around, it's a mess.
Yeah, and also,
there's a child upstairs as well that's just gone to bed. So that's why we kind of whisper.
We try and keep it as lo-fi as possible because that's what we are.
Yeah, that's right.
But I respect what you're saying. If you can't hear them, sometimes I get that. And sometimes it's because of we have to have a little bit quieter. But anyway, this is...
Oh, Funk Incorporated.
This is.
Yeah, that's off this album, Hanging Out.
Which we played years ago.
We played Smoking and Tiffany's because it was that culture rap break, but this is Dirty Red, so version of the Couch track, which is wicked. Anyway, it's very nice.
Yeah, very nice. And talking very nice, we had a very nice time on Saturday night with our good friends, Mr. Higgs and Mr. Parker.
That's right, it was so jammed. Would not believe how many people squeezed themselves into that huge cavern.
Yeah. Literally
bouncing off the walls, people.
Yeah. But thanks to the people who did come. Some people we knew.
Yeah, no, it was a brilliant night actually. It was really, really good.
I really enjoyed
it. And it was really good playing with Mr. Parker, who I have to say played some insanely good music. They stepped up their game since the last time we played.
You're saying they weren't very good last time?
No, I'm just saying they stepped up their game.
Okay. Yeah, they were wicked. Yeah. I was like an excited child.
Totally.
I mean, obviously we played brilliant tracks as well.
They weren't a patch on us.
Yeah, I mean they were good. They were excellent. It was really good fun. I can't wait to do it again.
Totally.
Yeah. But anyway,
next up we got this little single by The Counts actually, and it's on Janus Records, and it's Thinking Single.
This is The Counts.
Thinking Single. Yeah, very nice indeed. Little 45. Yes, they certainly know how to get down, as do we.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do, it's true. We haven't got any other gigs coming up, although I was offered one the other day. I got to chase up an email that I got sent, and I just haven't got back to them. So I've got to make the effort. I sent to Andy the other day that I'm going to make the effort to book in at least something once a month, something regular, and then something irregular, so a couple of gigs a month.
Yeah, I'd like to haul myself out a bit more. Very good for the young kids. Oh, it is lazy.
I think people got fed up of asking us.
I mean, Brad's just popped round and I just sort of like, go in there, Brad, I've just got to quickly read a bedtime story to my son. And then, where it goes.
Now it's going to be a bedtime story to me.
Anyway, this is nice. Next up, we've got a bit of Mongo Santa Maria and his version of We Got Latin Soul, which is awesome. Very nice indeed.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I gave my thoughts on the Roxanne thing last week. What did you think, Brad?
Much the same as you, Chris. Yeah. I thought it was disappointing.
It was a bit.
I thought it didn't focus enough on music in a strange way. You know, like, you want it to focus on music. It's like when I watched Ray, I thought Ray was a great film, but it focused so much on drugs and that side of his character that it was like, surely we're here to celebrate the music.
Totally.
You know?
But it was good. I do like the Defiant ones though.
Yeah, you said, yeah, really Jimmy good. Iovine. And,
really good. Yeah, that's good that is.
Story of Headphones.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Very good indeed. Right. Very nice.
Yeah. I haven't started watching that yet.
No, it's good. Yeah, you should.
I did watch Isle of Dogs, my regular movie reviews on that show. Wes Anderson's Isle of Dogs, and that was really good. A bit strange, but you can't help but look at little bits and pieces like you can with most of these movies.
Cool.
I watched Ready Player One as well, which is alright. I like the Spielberg movie.
Oh, I can't remember if I've watched anything. No.
Anyway, this is
Ricky. Yeah, it's
Ricky. Anyway,
a nice guy who comes into the shop. He owns a jeweller's and also sells records.
Yeah, Norfolk.
And he's an Israeli guy called Amir. And he put me onto this. Now, I knew that there was a super expensive sort of psych album by the Churchills, but I didn't know that there was a sort of reissue sort of thing. It's pretty damn good, actually. Let's have a listen.
For me, there's a couple of other crackers on it as well.
There is, yeah. Signs of You, this is.
So the jeweller bought it in.
I went to him.
Oh, did you? Yeah. My mum hooked me up to him, and I've only been there once.
Yeah. Did you go downstairs?
No, I didn't either, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it Effective Special Friends? Yeah. Is it like that bit downstairs?
Well, he's offering that place to me to sort of like have as a shop.
Really?
For half the price of what I'm paying for the place.
Downstairs?
Yeah.
Really? People come to Norfolk as much as they come to South Arrow.
I don't know. It's on a bloody high street.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
But it's right next to the station. It's on the Met Line.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah.
But, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's nice.
Yeah.
Have we got anything else to plug, have we, really?
No, not really. There's a lot going on, but yeah. I haven't really done my reading this week.
Yeah,
really too busy at Easter weekend eating chocolate.
Still not on the.
Still doing good.
Still doing good, man. Yeah, no sugar since January the 1st.
That's good. Since January the 1st.
Yeah.
Wow. No sugar for Chris.
No sugar. But next up, we have got a bit of Juicy Lucy. So,
yeah. It is sugar there.
It's a good album, I tell you. So let's have a go. Sexy.
Cover's amazing.
Yeah.
It's got watermelon juice dripping all over it.
Yeah. And this track is called Nadine.
Nadine, whoever you are, you inspired a nice track. I don't know if that's your full cover.
That's Lucy, surely.
Well, you guys would think so, but you never know, do you?
Yeah, good. It's always nice to get a vertigo swirly for cheap.
So we didn't mention the shop, so if you are in the market for some fantastic bundles, I went to the shop on Saturday and got some crackers, some of which we're playing tonight. But yeah, so South Arrow, opposite South Arrow Piccadilly Line Station.
Yes.
Cross the road, find some bargains.
That's right, and obviously it's Easter holiday, so I am actually there all day. So
there you go,
and on Saturdays obviously.
Wow.
I'm going to a little cheeky record fair on Saturday morning, so I might be a little bit late.
Are you?
No.
Where is it?
Norfolk.
I'm coming. Am I allowed to come? Sure. Have you just marked your territory?
I don't know where it is, because it's like someone's decided to do one.
Well, in your house?
Yeah.
My record fair.
Yeah. Cambridge, Queen. Anyway.
All the Kylie's are 7 pence.
Yeah. I went to see a massive collection tonight, actually.
Did you?
Yeah.
Is it good?
Nah, it was all classical. And do you know what? I mean, and it looked lovely. It looked. I didn't see any of these rare sort of stereo 50s sort of things or anything like that, but it all looked lovely. It was all impeccable. There was seriously about 500 of them, I think.
Wow.
You know, but I'm like, what am I going to do with them? You know what I mean?
Nothing.
No,
they would take up room.
They would have taken up room, so I'll pass them on to somebody else. So. Oh, if anybody out there wants a load of classical, then
there you go.
Give me a holler. Anyway, this is cool. Next up, we've got a nice late bit of Ramsey Lewis.
Yeah, this is a cracker.
Yeah, Shining.
Ramsey Lewis.
Shining!
There's a good bit in that Ready Player One. Because obviously, if anyone has read the book or knows about it, it's all set in virtual reality.
Okay.
And one of the quests they've got to do is in the film, The Shining.
Oh, really?
And even that bit scared me. 1977, look at Ramsey's hands.
I'm not going to hurt you, Wendy. I'm just going to bash your brains in.
Yeah.
It's one of my favourite films, I'd say.
Where's Rusty? I forgot. Rusty's supposed to come home with little gifts. Let's give him a call. Yep. Still alive and going strong.
Yeah.
Hands up if you're one of the greatest pinners of all time.
Yeah. Next up.
The
think we played any of this. Either way, it's Robert Palmer. And I know that there's Robert Palmer albums with breaks on and stuff. But this album, don't see it that often, really. But all of the music is by The Meters. You can just tell, can't you?
Yes, you can, straight away.
It's like an outtake from the Rejuvenation album, or Cabbage Alley, or something like that. But with Robert Palmer singing instead.
It's a good album.
Nice and lit.
Calls. It's called
Sneaking
Sally Through the Alley.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Dirty boy.
Dirty Sally.
There you go. Yeah, we're staying with these sort of blue-eyed soul sort of.
Yes, we are.
For a bit. And the next time we've got Bob Seger. Now, we played a track off of this years and years ago. It's a killer track, yeah. 2+2 on my mind. But there's a killer track here called White Wall, and I guess it's going to be our sort of break of the week because I forgot to find one. But there is drums at the beginning ish. So there you go. Bob Seger. Good album, this, I tell you.
Yes.
It's got Rambling Gambling Man, all those sorts of things. 1968.
Yes, 2+2.
Yeah. I've been told all of his early albums are worth picking up, so do it. Yeah, very nice too.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, we played 2+2 about the fourth show.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. A lot of people have been watching Cookie Crew again lately.
Have they?
Yeah. Quite strange. I've had some messages about it. And
oh, really? Oh, yeah. Well, that is,
we're down about 8,000 views now.
Cool.
They're popular.
They are. Well, they, why wouldn't they be then?
Oh, yeah, why wouldn't they be, yeah.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah, really nice. Directed by Peter Ustinov.
Yeah, I know, yeah. That's, I remember having this conversation before. This is why I remember the tune.
Okay.
The film, sorry, yeah.
Well, he was...
I've never seen the film.
He was an exceptionally clever guy, wasn't he?
Yes.
So, Peter Ustinov.
Yeah.
Always like watching those old interviews with him. And
he was smart.
Yeah, smart and had so many cool things to talk about.
He invented the thing he did that with at school.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Peter Ustinov a minute ago.
Really?
On the set of Hammersmith Out.
Wow, there you go.
Really. He's a smart guy, though.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I watched Zulu yesterday. I thought it was Bank Holiday. I watched
Zulu. I've got the soundtrack in the shop, actually.
Yeah.
Spawn the Zulu Nation.
There you go.
Film.
What was I going to say? There was something I was going to say before that, then.
Other films you might have watched over?
No, it was
incredible.
I watched this. Did you? Is it good?
Yeah, what? It weren't bad.
Yeah.
You know, with the kids liked it, so that's all bad.
I was going to watch Something Free. Despicable Me Free.
That's awesome.
Is it good? I was going to watch that or Cars Free as well.
Yeah. I like the Cars films, but Despicable Me films and the Minions film, they are fucking brilliant.
Really?
So, so good. I've watched them so many times, it is unreal.
Fair enough.
The Despicable
Me, you'd like it as well.
You like it because it's all like set in the 80s.
Oh, really?
Well, not set in the 80s, but the baddie is an 80s baddie.
Oh, really?
He's got like a mullet and a moustache and he sort of moonwalks and sort of
really?
Like an air
I'll
guitars.
Watch it, yeah.
So, you know what I mean? It's brilliant. It's so good.
Watch that when I get in. It's like to watch The Bridge, a Scando drama. Haven't seen it, looks really good. Started to watch the first one last night, I was like, dark. What I was going to say is that I'm making a vow and a promise right now. Chris, you've got a year. I had a conversation with Format a little while ago and we spoke about I'm 45, he's 45 this year, you're 45 next year, Justice has got to be 45 this year.
Oh, he's, yeah.
And we said
he's
we all
47,
should...
surely.
Yeah, 51. he looks about 29 still. But what I've said is, what me and Matt said was, we should do 45 mixes for our 45th year. And I was like, got to do that. So
totally.
I have started pulling tracks out. I was chatting to the boys, Mr. Higg and Mr. Parker, about the other night. I'm going to do it.
Because they're
it's going to be
in
here.
In fact, Mr. Park is 46.
Well, there you go. He should have done... He's just got to do an extra track then. But yeah, so I'm going to get that up within 6 weeks.
Cool.
So you've got a year.
Yeah.
Yeah, but cool. We'll catch you next week. Bye-bye.